Ostan deno vitu domeni misericordia tua.
Et salutare tua
Domine exa di oratia namaeva.
Et omne salve mia.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cus
Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritus tuo.
Sequentia sancti angelii secundum, amen.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
Vino la tambora, cum apertuis atque, gelosis, et venis in te parte ad hominem olivet, cum quis virtuosis in grosso, dicense, ide in castem, quod patra vosa, et statim in de me, quis asim amadicam, et curum cum ea, Colim, eraducit eti, et sic vis vobis salicus dixe, dicit, quia Dominus vis potest fata, ad factum est in tibi, et eo. Quam apud totum facunda, ut ad interveditum, cordicum est perpetuum dicendo, dicit et iisti io, et eget tuos venitim, manfei, sedet super asina metum, filium subjugami. Eum exaltum dicit, vecerum sicut precepi, iis est. Eratus terram nasi, et cur, et in posto verbum super eos esines nascuo, ob eum ne super sedere fecerum. Dorima apum corda supra verbum esines nascuo in vivum, adia apum saede mandamus de arborius, externa apant in vivum, corve apum, quae pecede pas, et quae sepe fato clamabat dicenda, pas mana filio gravi, te dedicus, qui venit in nomine Domini.
Thank you.
singurul valor, optamus gestam, solemnis laudus de cantabim, concede propicii, ut quocumque in iramete portate in credi, ibique benedizione in gratia descendo, et quahit demon, iniquitat, per illusione erotica, desca la tua proteca, postre degli, vivi per su regno, in unicate Spiritu Sancti Deo, et omnia secula, seculorum.
Oh, Lord, The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus came with them into a country place, which is called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples,
"Sit you here till I go yonder in prayer."
And taking with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, he began to grow sorrowful and to be sad. Then he saith to them,
"My soul is sorrowful even unto death. Stay you here and watch with me."
And going a little further, he fell upon his face, praying and saying,
"My Father, if it be possible, let this chalice pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt."
And he cometh to his disciples, and findeth them asleep. And he saith to Peter,
Watch, do not watch 1 hour with the men. Watch ye and pray, that ye get not entered into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak.
Again the second time, he went and prayed, saying,
My Father, if this chalice may not pass away, but I must drink it, thy will be done.
And he cometh again, and findeth them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. And leaving them, he went again, and he prayed the third time, saying the selfsame word. Then he cometh to his disciples, and saith to them,
Sleep ye now, and take your rest. Behold, the hour is at hand. The Son of Man shall be betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise. Let us go behold, he is at hand, that will betray me.
As he yet spoke, behold, Judas, one of the 12, came, and with him a great multitude with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests and the ancients of the people. And he that betrayed him gave them a sign, saying,
Whomsoever I shall kiss, that is he. Hold him fast.
And forthwith coming to Jesus, he said,
Hail, Rabbi.
And he kissed him. And Jesus said to him,
Friend, whereto art thou come?
Then they came up and laid hands on Jesus and held him. And behold, one of them that were with Jesus, stretching forth his hand, drew out his sword, and striking the servant of the high priest, cut off his ear. Then Jesus saith to him,
Put up again my sword into its place, for all that take the sword shall perish with the sword. Thinkest thou that I cannot ask my Father, and he will give thee presently more than 12 legions of angels? How then shall the scripture be fulfilled, that so it must be?
In that same hour, Jesus said to the multitudes,
You are come out, as it was for robbers, with swords and clubs to apprehend me. I sat daily with you, teaching in the temple, and you laid not hands on me.
Now all this was done that the scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled. Then the disciples, all leaving him, fled. But they, holding Jesus, led him to Caiaphas the high priest, where the scribes and the ancients were assembled. And Peter followed him afar off, even to the court of the high priest. And going in, he sat with the servants, that he might see the end. And the chief priests and the whole council sought false witness against Jesus, that they might put him to death. And they found none, whereas many false witnesses had come in. And last of all, there came two false witnesses, and they said,
This man said, I am able to destroy the temple of God, and after 3 days to rebuild it.
And the high priest, rising up, said to him,
Answerest thou nothing to the things with which these witness against thee?
But Jesus held his peace. And the high priest said to him,
I adjure thee by the living God that thou tell us if thou be the Christ, the Son of God.
Jesus saith to him,
Thou hast said, Nevertheless I say to you, hereafter you shall see the Son of Man coming, sitting on the right hand of the power of God, and coming in the clouds of heaven.
Then the high priest rent his garments, saying,
He hath blasphemed. What further need have we of witnesses? Behold, now you have heard the blasphemy. What think you?
But they answering said,
He is guilty of death.
Then did they spit in his face and buffeted him, and others struck his face with the palms of their hands, saying,
Prophesy unto us, O Christ, Who is he that struck him?
But Peter sat without in the court, and there came to him a servant maid, saying,
Thou also wast with Jesus the Galilean.
But he denied before them all, saying,
I know not what thou sayest.
And as he went out of the gate, another maid saw him, and she said to them that were there,
This man also was with Jesus of Nazareth.
And again he denied with an oath, I do not know the man. And after a little while, they came that stood by and said to Peter,
Surely thou also art one of them, for even thy speech doth discover thee.
Then he began to curse and to swear that he knew not the man, and immediately the cock crew. And Peter remembered the word of Jesus, which he had said, Before the cock crow, thou wilt deny me thrice. And going forth, he wept bitterly. And when morning was come, all the chief priests and ancients of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. And they brought him bound and delivered him to Pontius Pilate the governor. Then Judas, who betrayed him, seeing that he was condemned, repenting himself, brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and ancients, saying,
I have sinned in betraying innocent blood.
But they said,
What is that to us? Look thou to it.
And casting down the pieces of silver in the temple, he departed, and went and hanged himself with a halter. But the chief priests, having taken the pieces of silver, said,
It is not lawful to put them into the carbonum, because it is the price of blood.
And after they had consulted together, they brought with them the potter's field, to be a burying place for strangers. Wherefore that field was called Hasseldam, that is, the field of blood, even to this day. Then was fulfilled what that which was spoken by Jeremiah the prophet, saying, And they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him that was prized, whom they prized of the children of Israel, and they gave them unto the potter's field, as the Lord appointed to me. And Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, saying,
Art thou the king of the Jews?
Jesus saith to him, And when he was accused by the chief priests and ancients, he answered nothing. Then Pilate saith to him,
Dost not thou hear how great testimonies they allege against thee?
And he answered to him never a word, so that the governor wondered exceedingly. Now upon the solemn day, the governor was accustomed to release to the people one prisoner, whom they would. And he had then a notorious prisoner that was called Barabbas. They therefore being gathered together, Pilate said,
Whom will you that I release to you, Barabbas or Jesus that is called Christ?
For he knew that for envy they had delivered him. And as he was sitting in the place of judgment, his wife sent to him, saying,
Have thou nothing to do with that just man? For I have suffered many things this day in a dream because of him.
But the chief priests and ancients persuaded the people that they should ask Barabbas and make Jesus away. And the governor answering said to them,
Whether will you of the two to be released unto you?
But they said,
Barabbas.
Pilate saith to them,
What shall I do then? With Jesus that is called Christ.
They say all,
Let him be crucified.
The governor said to them,
Why, what evil hath he done?
But they cried out the more, saying,
Let him be crucified.
And Pilate, seeing that he prevailed nothing, but that rather a tumult was made, taking water, washed his hands before the people, saying,
I am innocent of the blood of this just man. Look you to it.
And the whole people answering said,
His blood be upon us and upon our children.
Then he released them Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, delivered him unto them to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor, taking Jesus into the hall, gathered together unto him the whole band, and stripping him, they put a scarlet cloak about him, and plaiting a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand. And bowing the knee before him, they mocked him, saying,
Hail, King of the Jews!
And spitting upon him, they took the reed and struck his head. And after they had mocked him, they took off the cloak from him, and put on him his own garments, and led him away to crucify him. And going out, they found a man of Cyrene, named Simon. Him they forced to take up his cross. And they came to the place that is called Golgotha, which is the place of Calvary. And they gave him wine to drink, mingled with gall. And when he had tasted, he would not drink. And after they had crucified him, they divided his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying, They divided my garments among them, and upon my vesture they cast lots. And they sat and watched him. And they put over his head his cause, written, This is Jesus, the King of the Jews. Then were crucified with him two thieves, one on the right hand and one on the left. And they that passed by blasphemed him, wagging their heads and saying,
Vah, thou hast destroyed the temple of God, and in 3 days doth rebuild it. Save thine own self, if thou be the Son of God. Come down from the cross.
In like manner also, the chief priests with the scribes and ancients mocking said,
He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God, let him now deliver him, if he will have him. For he said, I am the Son of God.
And the selfsame thing the thieves also that were crucified with him reproached him with. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over the whole earth until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying,
Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?
That is,
my God, why hast thou forsaken me?
And some that stood there and heard said,
This man is calling Elias.
And immediately one of them running took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on a reed and gave him to drink. And the others said,
Let be, let us see whether Elias will come to deliver him.
And Jesus again crying with a loud voice yielded up the ghost. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in two from the top even to the bottom. And the earth quaked, and the rocks were rent, and the graves were opened. And many bodies of the saints that had slept arose, and coming out of the tombs after his resurrection, came into the holy city and appeared to many. Now the centurion and they that were with him, watching Jesus, having seen the earthquake, and the things that were done, were sore afraid, saying,
Indeed, this was the Son of God.
And there were there many women afar off, who had followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering unto him, among whom was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of the sons of Zebedee. And when it was evening, there came a certain rich man of Arimathea, named Joseph, who was also himself was a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked the body of Jesus. Then Pilate commanded that the body should be delivered. And Joseph, taking the body, wrapped it up in a clean linen cloth and laid it in his own new monument, which he had hewn out in a rock. And he rolled a great stone to the door of the monument and went his way. Please be seated. The intention for Holy Mass on this Palm Sunday is for our Fumio Manabar, crucified on Fumio Manabar. Then a reminder about our Holy Week schedule. On Spy Wednesday, this coming Wednesday, March 27th, the ceremony of Tenebrae will begin at 7 in the evening. Holy Thursday, March 28th, Holy Mass will begin at 8:30 in the evening. For Friday, the pre-sanctified liturgy, the ceremony will begin at 3, followed by the outdoor procession, and for our Holy Saturday, Easter Vigil, we begin the ceremonies at 10:30. Reminder for the collection, the first is for all the souls of the parish, and the second is for the Don Contest. We will have our convivium today, immediately following the Holy Mass. Now let us kneel for the memorare. The love of God will continue to protect the Latin Mass here at all the stars and throughout the world, lest its enemies prevail. Remember, it was most gracious to the Mary, that the Lord is alone, and anyone who fled to thy protection, and glory and honor, so thy intercession. Inspired by this confidence, fly to thee, O Virgin and Virgins, our Mother, to thee we come before thee in demons, his folk, and sorrow. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise our petitions, and in thy plans see your next end. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. All together standing outside the church a few minutes ago to not have escaped from us the heavy, mystical symbolism that we were living through. All of us standing outside representing all the fallen children of Adam and Eve, you and I, afflicted by original sin. The church, of course, with its locked doors in front of which we stood, this is paradise. Or in the topology of the church, it is here that there is the New Jerusalem. As the choir sat
as the choir sang outside the church and we listened, they were the cries of you and I, poor banished children of Eve, wanting desperately to come to heaven. And if you listen carefully, some of the choir were on the inside of the church, and they were singing, chanting. They represented to us the angels of heaven, waiting for us, recognizing that we were unable to enter until Christ shed his blood on Calvary. The priest representing the Alter Christus waits for the crucifer to bang on the doors of the church, almost like an angel, announcing that Christ is here to open the gates of paradise. The doors came open, and you and I marched in to heaven. There's other symbolism, mystical symbolism today. The palms, the blessed palms that we hold in our hands, as the Jews did 2,000 years ago. We know that on Palm Sunday they raised those palms to declare Christ their king, and only several days later they raised their fists and begged Pilate to crucify him. Why? Because their love was superficial. They did not want to abandon their hearts to the heart of the Savior. They simply wanted him to be a beneficiary, taking care of him through his might and power. All they wanted was signs and wonders. They did not want grace and salvation. As you and I hold our blessed palms at this moment, here is that double mystical symbolism. On the one hand, we will bring those palms home as a sign to us for the rest of the year that we stand in the dominion of Christ, the King of Kings. And yet, know full well that like those Jews 2,000 years ago, our love often falters. Because our love is fickle, one day the love of Christ runs through us with great sanguinity, and tomorrow it grows cool. Our love is weak, because all too often it depends upon sentiment and feeling rather than the heroic strength of virtue. How happy we are when our Lord sends us his blessings. And how unconsolable we are when he chooses to send us his crosses. Indeed, we will hold our blessed palms today and bring them home as a sign that you and I are subjects of the King of Kings, but also recognize that we are subjects who at any moment can turn traitor. Thank you.
Oh, Oh.
enigmam proces, factico oidis quid, ut omnem mons ode Eva habo, Oh. No, just walk back, pack my clothes.
Amen.
Thank you.
Domingos vobis. Per voius Domine operation mysterium, adicia nostra progenito, ad gusta de fideria conteianto, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regna in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Domingos vobis. Father, and Filius, and Spiritus Sanctus.